The Lyme Bay long-term monitoring project started in 2008 when Lyme Bay had a huge area protected from bottom toad fishing. It's 200 square kilometres. We're in the middle of it here in Lyme Regis, and it extends to the east, to West Bay, and then all the way to Beer. And since that happened, we've been monitoring how the seabed has recovered from this damaging activity.
We'll meet in the morning, look at the conditions, think about the tides, and we'll work through a set of sites. We have over 60 sites that we've visited doing transects for 10 years now. Over the course of a season, we'll accumulate approximately 12,000 metres of transect footage, which is a huge amount of footage, and it will take many months. It will take months locked away in a dark room just staring at the video screen. But it's quite rewarding, it's quite exciting when you find something that's new or something that's really interesting, and just seeing how the sites differ and change over time.
This project is probably one of the UK's best example of a long-term monitoring project. So the fact we've got 10 years data is really, really exciting and important for the UK.
I started fishing in the 60s, early 60s. So yes, a very, very long time when you think about it. Yeah.
The first change that I noticed was obviously within the shellfish with crabs and lobsters predominantly. And the first thing that I noticed was an increase in the quality. And not so much the quantity, but the quality of what we were catching.
Both as a fisherman and as a charter boat skipper, I think the important thing is that analysis being done over a good period of time, that's got to be the best quality evidence that you can have.
Since the area has been protected, when we first got here, it didn't look very impressive and we didn't really know why they protected this area. But over time, suddenly like the seabed just erupted and we were seeing lots of sponges and pink sea fans and scallops and crabs and fishes. So the recovery has been really, really impressive.
The problem was that it became a magnet for static gear, for large numbers of pots and nets. And that was beginning to drag up the very reefs that had been theoretically protected. And so Blue Marine Foundation, my charity, suggested to the local regulators, to the scientists, to the fishermen, to other conservationists, that we should set up a working group to try and address this problem and manage Lyme Bay and its reefs sustainably.
Of course, we have differences between ourselves about the way in which we're moving and how we should, and yeah, but we're actually very lucky, and certainly I think it's probably unique. It's certainly unique to the UK, and it's probably unique to the planet actually, that we've got a forum where the fishermen and those people who are charged with enforcing the rules, conservationists, are all able to come along and put in their two penneth, like, and it not be poo-pooed. So I think Blue's great gift to us is that forum.
So yeah, I think it's, we support the work that's being done because we all, fishermen always sort of moan if decisions are taken with no knowledge. So at least with some knowledge, you know, it's got to be a better idea.
DEFRA funded the first 4 years of this research, and then amazingly Natural England, some other charities including Blue Marine Foundation and Plymouth University all helped to keep this monitoring going every single year. And we're really excited because the next 2 years of the project are being funded by the EU European Maritime Fisheries Fund. And the European funding that allows us to continue to do our long-term monitoring means that this really important research can be used by the fishermen to demonstrate that their fishing is sustainable.